Coach Jim Clemens of the Lakers is a living, breathing basketball institution. For almost 40 years, he's been involved in the highest levels of the NBA, winning 8 championships. As a player, Clemens was teammates of Jerry West and Will Chamberlain on the 1971-72 Lakers that won 33 straight games, a record that no other professional team in any other sport has been able to break. As a coach, Clemens has worked with Michael Jordan, Scottie Pippen, Jason Kidd, Shaquille O'Neal, Kobe Bryant, Pau Gasol, just to name a few. But Clemens is not only a basketball genius, he's also a great role model. And recently, he took time from his busy schedule to come down and volunteer to give the students at Emek Hebrew Academy, a Jewish elementary school right here in Los Angeles, a basketball clinic.
Everybody's hoping now, the clock's run out, time's up, over, black.
You cannot lose the gelt in the game of the dreidel, not able to never ever let it go. You only get one shot, you got to let on, get more. Those chocolate Jewish trees come once in a nighttime, yo.
Just days after returning from the longest road trip in Lakers history, Coach Clemens was back in the gym, working with some of Los Angeles' youngest players. I asked, why did he decide to come give this clinic?
And what good is knowledge if you don't share?
See how smooth it is now? With your elbows to your side. Alright? See, I'll be way out like this, okay? That's one correction we want to make on our technique. Just try to bring those elbows down. If you take a step to receive the basketball or take a step into your pass,
they don't want to dunk.
Another person who was a big part of the clinic was 7'2" Josh Moore. Josh, a former Clipper, has played professional basketball in China and Iran. He tells me it's great to see how the game brings people together.
We have a lot of similarities in a lot of the things that we do, but basketball is definitely an ultimate uniter.
Besides, he has tons of experience and is happy to share it.
18 years I've been involved with basketball. You know, I've learned a few things over the years, you know, and how's that old saying go? Experience is what you get when you don't get what you want, so. You know, I've got a lot of experience.
Fiddler on the roof set. I don't leave my tradition. That means it's a time for celebration. People, are you ready? Come on.
Now, when I was a much younger man, I loved to dunk. But as you get older, you realize that 2 points is 2 points.
Coach Clemens also took some questions from the students, and let me tell you, it was almost like being in an NBA news conference.
Can the Lakers win the championship this year? Yeah.
Well, until you eliminate, you always have a chance to win the championship, okay? But I'll go out on a limb if. And if the biggest two-letter word in the dictionary, okay? If. See, right now, as I look at our basketball team, we're not tough enough to win a championship. All right? And I say that having 8 championships underneath my belt. Okay? We're not tough enough to win a championship as we stand right now. We give up too many second shots. We don't play good enough defense. And we don't offensive rebound enough for our misses. Because when it comes to winning a championship, you got to take care of your business. And we're not taking care of our business. That doesn't mean that we won't, because between now and then, we have to grow. We have to grow up here.
How did Kobe dislocate his pinky?
How did Kobe dislocate his pinky? He deflected the pass, or he got his hand caught. You know, we wear the jerseys, right? Either that, but he came in at halftime, and he was telling the trainer, I can't remember, he said, he got his hand on pass, or he got his pinky caught in the jersey.
What was your biggest disappointment, either in a game or a season, or of all the years you've been doing this?
I was hurt that the year that we lost to Detroit, I thought we had a championship caliber team. Karl Malone got hurt, Horace Grant got hurt, and our last game we ended up starting Slava Mathedinka.
How do you feel about the Shaq trade?
Well, that's, as I was talking to Matt coming in, Shaquille's the type of person, when you tell him he can't do something, he's going to set out to prove you wrong. So I wish the media would not tell him what he can't do and just leave him alone, and then I think he will be okay.
Coach Clemons also told the students what was he like when he was a kid.
And I didn't like the game of basketball. The ball was too big, the bucket was too high. I gravitated to the sport of baseball. It was easy for me to throw, I could catch it, I could control it. But there was something about the game of basketball that stayed with me. You gotta be prepared for what you want. My mom used to say a lot of my life, be careful what you ask for, because you just might get it. Okay? So when I started to grow, and the game of basketball was still in my blood, in my genes, I need to have skills in order to be successful. If you want to be a good basketball player, you have to start today. You have to start as soon as you possibly can. It's a sport that you have to give love to. Hours and hours of time. So from the ninth grade till I was a senior in college, I devoted almost 5 to 6 hours a day, especially in the off season, to playing this game of basketball. And I say that because in that 5 or 6 hours a day that I put forth in basketball in the off season, I had academics, I had chores at home, and I had to earn my own spending money. So there's a responsibility that if you want to be an athlete, you got to take care of home first. You got to do the things that your mom and dad want you to do around the house, be it academics, be it chores, take care of your room. Because there's three things that are important to me: my family, my education, and my basketball.
Hey, how impressed I was listening to you. And how eloquent you spoke to everybody. Also, that you spoke about a couple of philosophies that you have. One, you said to us that you want to have peace at home, and we call that shalom bayit. And the other thing you said is that in order to be successful on the court, you have to give to get, and we call that tzedakah. And the other thing that you said, Coach, that I remember was that it's all for the good. And we call that Gamzela Tova. So I just want to say that if your career ever comes to an end, we have a yarmulke.
To Coach Clemons, thank you for your dedication and generosity. Emek Hebrew Academy, 2008.
How did it go today?
I think it was spectacular. The coach was just sensational. Spoke just every word counted, and the kids were so attentive, so perfect, so well behaved. And I think part of the reason was they felt that they were in the presence of somebody that knew what he was talking about.
Did you imagine that he'd be so hands-on and so into it, or did you think this would be just one of those?
I thought it was just going to be a regular clinic where, you know, but he went from kid to kid. Taught him everything. Didn't want to leave him until he really saw that the kid grasped the knowledge and knew what he was talking about. It was incredible.
And how was it today? How was the clinic?
Fun.
Was it worthwhile?
Yeah.
What do you think about Josh?
He's a cool man.
He's a cool man. And how about Coach Clemons?
He's a good teacher.
He's a good teacher. He knows a lot about basketball.
Okay, bye-bye.
In Los Angeles, I'm Elie seckbach.